Hello, our dear viewers. Today, we will talk about Wi-Fi 6, Wi-Fi 6E, and the upcoming Wi-Fi 7 wireless networks. Wi-Fi 6, also known as 802.11ax, is a wireless networking standard that provides high-speed internet connectivity. It is the successor to Wi-Fi 5, also known as 802.11ac, and is designed to be faster, more efficient and more capable of handling a greater number of connected devices. One of the key features of a Wi-Fi 6 is its ability to support higher data rates, which allows it to transfer data more quickly than previous versions of Wi-Fi. It also has improved efficiency and can handle more devices at once without experiencing any slowdown. This makes it ideal for use in crowded environments such as apartments, office buildings, and public spaces. Wi-Fi 6 also includes a number of other advanced features, such as orthogonal frequency division multiplexing, OFDMA, which allows multiple devices to communicate with their router at the same time, and target wait time, which allows devices to sleep and wake up at predetermined intervals to conserve battery life. To take advantage of the improved performance and features of Wi-Fi 6, you will need a device that is compatible with the standard, such as a smartphone, laptop or router that supports Wi-Fi 6. Regarding speed, Wi-Fi 6 has a maximum data rate of 9.6 gigabits per second, which is significantly faster than the maximum data rate of Wi-Fi 5, which is 3.5 gigabits per second. However, it's important to note that the actual speed of a Wi-Fi 6 connection will depend on a number of factors, including the distance between the device and the router, the presence of interference from other electronic devices, and the type of device being used. In real-world scenarios, it is unlikely that the Wi-Fi 6 connection will achieve maximum speeds, but it should still be significantly faster than a Wi-Fi 5 connection. Some estimates suggest that a Wi-Fi 6 connection could be up to 40% faster than a Wi-Fi 5 connection, depending, of course, on the specific circumstances. It's also worth noting that Wi-Fi 6 is designed to be more efficient than previous versions of Wi-Fi, so it may be able to maintain higher speeds even when there are many devices connected to the network. The frequencies the Wi-Fi 6 uses. Wi-Fi 6 operates on two different frequency bands, the 2.4 GHz band and the 5 GHz band. They are the same as Wi-Fi 5, but it utilizes them more efficiently. Now, let's talk about Wi-Fi 6E. Wi-Fi 6E is an extension of the Wi-Fi 6 standard that allows for the use of the 6 GHz frequency band in addition to the 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz bands. The 6 GHz band is a relatively new frequency band that was recently made available for use by wireless devices. It is generally considered to be less crowded and less prone to interference than the 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz bands, which makes it ideal for high bandwidth applications such as gaming, streaming, and online video conferencing. To use Wi-Fi 6E, you will need a device that is compatible with the 6 GHz frequency band. This could be a smartphone, laptop, or router that has been designed to operate on the 6 GHz band. Once you have a Wi-Fi 6E compatible device and you are in an area where the 6 GHz band is available, you can simply connect to Wi-Fi 6E network in the same way you could connect to any other Wi-Fi network. The device will automatically detect the available frequency bands and choose the one that offers the best performance based on factors such as distance, interference, and the presence of other devices. Now, let's talk about Wi-Fi 7. Wi-Fi 7 is the upcoming Wi-Fi standard, also known as IEEE 802.11be, extremely high throughput. It works across all three bands, 2.4, 5 GHz and 6 GHz, to fully utilize spectrum resources. While Wi-Fi 6 was built in response to the growing number of devices in the world, Wi-Fi 7 has as a goal to deliver outstanding speeds for every device with greater efficiency. If you are struggling with constant buffering and congestion, a Wi-Fi 7 router may be your best solution in these cases. Wi-Fi 7 introduces 320 MHz ultra wide bandwidth, 4096 QM multi-U and multi-link operation to provide speeds almost up to 5 times faster than Wi-Fi 6 and 13 times faster than Wi-Fi 5. In theory, it can achieve speeds up to 46 gigabits per second compared to 9.6 gigabits per second of Wi-Fi 6. And in real world scenarios, it is expected to reach up to 30 gigabits per second. Well, that was all the information we had about Wi-Fi 6, Wi-Fi 6E, and Wi-Fi 7 in simple terms. Should you have any questions, don't hesitate to write in the comments. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to be notified about our future videos.